project, six-inch panels. So this little mechanism right here tells me it's exactly at 16 inches. Bring this all back, drop it down to the guard. I know it's exactly a quarter of an inch below. I like to clamp it, make sure it's nice and square. Just gives it a little extra security. Now for roof cutting, you want to use the included auxiliary sag fence. This actually acts like a huge cutter board, very easy to use. Using the scale on the back of the machine, let's say we want to roof cut this at exactly 12 inches. Put it on the 12 inch mark. You're going to drop the saw so that it just goes into the groove, touches the bottom, lift it up slightly so you don't ruin the groove. Bring your auxiliary sag fence down. Now what we have is we have the main side fence here, the auxiliary side fence here. So now it's simply a case of pushing it through. Another unique thing about this particular machine is we can actually use it as a huge miter table. So we can set this to 45 degrees, if we want a 45 degree cut, put it in the machine, and clamp your panel, which this is, at exactly 45 degrees. Now the other thing you can do is you can mark your tabletop at all different degrees, in other words, put a whole miter gauge right on your tabletop. So it's as easy as bringing a sheet and laying it on the table. Now that we have it set at exactly 45 degrees, half of the cut all the way through. Now I'm only using a 42 blade, but you can see that that's a nice edge. For a 42 blade, that's not bad. Now, big thing is, let's see how it fits. Oh boy, you can't beat that. Okay, so now that we've done all of our rip cutting and cross cutting and miter cuts, now we're going to switch over to the rotor. The rotor only takes a few seconds to put in. Basically, you take the dust extraction off, you loosen up the four lockdown bolts. I've just made up a couple long, straight, these are just both 1x4s, and you'll notice I have a little stop block on there. The reason for that is, when I push this in, it will stop at exactly the same spot every time, and I have my rotary right here, so when I put my panel in, my router can actually router off the sides by this much, 12 inches, and let's put some at 24, and let's put the last one at 36. Now, I always put an X, the side that I want the rotor bit on. That'll make sense in a minute. So there's my mark, and there's my X. I know that the X, the rotor bit, is going to be to this side of the line. So we're going to feed these in. Now, because we're doing both at the same time, what we do want to do, we're making mirror image dados. We're going to take the ends and we're just going to clamp them together so they stay in perfect alignment. Okay, so our side guides, we're basically just going to clamp these in. On this side, I'll put a little block over here. And this is your basic setup for anything where you want to run in the X and Y axis. You can see our first mark is here. Remember, I put the X on my mark. Bring that down to my mark. I know that's exactly where I want it to be. Now, I want a 1-inch inset on both sides. So I don't want the shelf to go all the way to the end. I don't want to see the ugly. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to set up the rotor stuff. And we're going to give ourselves a 1-inch. Right there. And we're going to mark 1-inch over here. Bring the router stop over. That will stop exactly there. Do the same thing on this side. Bring the router bit over. Place it there. Is we set it back 1 inch from both sides using our rotor stops here and here, which will stop the whole rotor sled 1 inch short. Remember, they're mirror shelves, so that when we put them together, they'll be identical. lap joint. Line it down. Now we're going to go all the way to the end because we're making the lap turn at the top and bottom. Imagination what you can create on this machine. It truly is a manual